Hadoop and Cassandra are quite different products. Hadoop is designed to handle large amounts of data which needs to be processed at scale when you process a lot of data at the same time to get certain answers, or when you ingest large amounts of data in a streaming fashion or in a batch-like fashion at a very high sort of throughput, high scale. Hadoop is generally deployed in sort of a single location, single data center, you know, often multi-rack deployment, but they all sort of reasonably geographically co-located with each other. While Cassandra is frequently deployed at in a very distributed fashion. You may have some nodes or nodes in, you know, somewhere in Asia, you may have some in Europe, some in North America, East Coast and West Coast. So you end up with a very geographically distributed, always on, always very fault tolerant environment, and at the same time have very consistent performance. Cassandra is generally processing online workloads when you need to sort of interact in a more or less transactional basis, even though Cassandra doesn't really support transactions per se as we know them in sort of ACID compliant environments. It's basically handling a lot of interaction, lots of concurrent traffic, and each interaction is processing small amounts of data. And Cassandra requires certain structure. You actually have to put a lot of thinking into structuring your Cassandra data model before you're implementing that at scale, as opposed to Hadoop, which can accept data in variety of format, in pretty much any format, structured, unstructured, semi-structured, and so on, whatever you can think of, images, JSON, XML, and whatnot. So it's basically a file store, It's interesting that those two different products can actually be quite tightly integrated together. So sometimes you can see Hadoop deployed actually on top of Cassandra as a storage. So what it gives you, as opposed to Hadoop deploying on top of HDFS as a file store, a data store, it gives you ability to analyze the data that you generally have in Cassandra. So Cassandra is really great as a sort of backend for the online systems, very highly fault tolerant, but it's not really very analytics friendly as much as Hadoop. So if you put Hadoop on top of Cassandra, you can get a very sort of convenient way to have certain operational type analytic operational reporting, so you don't have to move data off Cassandra into Hadoop, into HDFS, in order to run some analytical workload on that. Now, it probably wouldn't like be at the scale of 1,000 nodes Hadoop cluster. Like on a Cassandra cluster, you may see like dozens of nodes in the Cassandra clusters, but it's a good way to provide you this operational level reporting on Cassandra, involving scanning reasonably large amounts of data, and at the same time without moving data off Cassandra into your Hadoop, into your HDFS for the analysis. And it's actually not very straightforward to extract data and incrementally move updates from Cassandra into Hadoop, especially more for real-time fashion. So it's a very convenient package to actually put those two together.